The Ursids meteor shower is an annual celestial event that happens from mid-December up until the winter solstice. This meteor shower is a bit more low-key than the Geminids meteor shower that precedes it in the first 2 weeks of December. In this video, we will explore the cause of the Ursids meteor shower, how many meteors you can expect to see, and get practice identifying Ursa Minor, the radiant for this meteor shower. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. The Ursids meteor shower is active annually between December 14th and December 24th, and it typically peaks around December 22nd and 23rd. At its peak, observers can view as many as 10 meteors per hour. In 2022, when this video is being recorded, the moon phase will be a waning crescent, which makes it an ideal time to go outside and try to view some of the meteors since the moonlight will be faint. The Ursids is associated with a comet known as 8P Tuttle. As comets travel around the sun, the dust they emit generally spreads out into a long, dusty trail within their own orbits. Each year, the Earth passes through these dusty debris trails, and these particles then enter our atmosphere, creating beautiful streaks across the sky. The comet known as 8P Tuttle is a periodic comet that orbits the sun every 13.6 years, and it's classified as a Jupiter family comet since its orbital period is less than 20 years. The closest this comet gets to the sun is around the same distance as the planet Earth, and it travels out as far as the planet Saturn. The comet 8P Tuttle last visited the inner solar system in August of 2021, and here you can see that's a picture of what comet 8P Tuttle looks like, and this right here is the spiral galaxy known as M33. Meteors are objects that glow due to friction while traveling through the Earth's atmosphere, and they appear as a streak of light in the sky, but they are often very small and no larger than a grain of sand. Here you can see what a meteor looks like from the International Space Station. It's entering the atmosphere and it begins to burn up. Before a meteor burns up in the atmosphere, it's classified as a meteoroid, a small rocky body in space. As it passes through the atmosphere, its classification changes into a meteor. And finally, when the meteor strikes the surface of the Earth, it becomes a meteorite. Meteor showers are celestial events that occur when the Earth passes through cosmic dust and debris left over by either comets or asteroids. They are often named after the place they appear to originate from in the sky. For example, the Ursids appear to originate from the constellation Ursa Minor. This is a photo of a meteor shower taken over the course of a few hours, and you can tell it was taken during this time because you can trace the streaks of light back to one origin point in the sky. Because all meteor showers are traveling in parallel paths at the same velocity, they will appear to an observer below to radiate from a single point in the sky. This effect is best seen in photos rather than when you're observing. And when you observe meteors, they will appear randomly in the sky. But if you photograph them, the streaks of light can be traced back to a common origin point, and we call this point the radiant. Meteor showers are named after the radiant, and in the case of the Ursids, the meteors will appear to originate from Ursa Minor. This radiant point is caused by the effect of perspective. It's similar to parallel railroad tracks converging at a single vanishing point on the horizon when viewed from the middle of the tracks. In the last portion of this video, we'll review over the pattern of Ursa Minor. And remember, as you observe in a meteor shower, they will appear randomly in the sky, so you don't necessarily need to look at Ursa Minor. However, I'm going to take any opportunity I can to teach about constellations. So, and especially if a meteor shower will help you to get outside and view the stars, it's a win-win for me. So as you're looking at this picture, you can probably notice the three brightest stars, and from there, are you able to point out the pattern of Ursa Minor. Here is what it looks like in the sky. And the best way to find Ursa Minor is to use Ursa Major, and specifically the asterism known as the Big Dipper, which is a smaller part of the larger constellation Ursa Major. You want to use the pointer stars in the Big Dipper to point you towards Polaris, and from there you can find where Ursa Minor is. You can also use Cassiopeia and that center star, use it like an arrow to point you towards Polaris. And Ursa Minor is represented as the Little Bear, and it is a very important constellation because it aims you in the direction of north. In fact, this star right here is known as Polaris, and it's the star that appears to never move in the sky. And the best way to find it, again, is to use the Big Dipper asterism. You want to use the pointer stars to point you towards Polaris. And I have a very detailed video on Ursa Minor as well as Ursa Major and Polaris. So if you want to learn more about that, be sure to go see that video. So I hope this video was helpful for you to learn about the Ursids, why we see them, when we can see them, and at its peak, you can see up to 10 meteors per hour. You may need to bundle up because it may be cold out there. So thank you so much for watching. I hope the weather treats you well and you have clear skies and that you can see the meteor shower known as the Ursids. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep looking up.